So in this video, I wanted to share with you the new feature on Leonardo, which upgrades everything, all the pictures, makes everything more realistic, more high fidelity, and it's called Alchemy. And I'm gonna show you the difference between what it does today and what it does with Alchemy, and then how to use it for print on demand. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna talk about Leonardo, Leonardo.AI, and Alchemy, its new beta switch feature that they have on there. It's in beta, so some of you may not have it. I was lucky to get it, so I'm gonna show you exactly what it does. I'm gonna do four different prompts, and I'll show you the difference with Alchemy and without Alchemy. Well, without Alchemy first, and then with Alchemy, and show you the extreme difference, like how much more fidelity, how much better it is. And then I'm gonna show you, taking that, I'm gonna scale it up, one of those prompts, I'm gonna scale it up and put it on a poster so that you can see how you would use it on print on demand. So these designs are more realistic, so it's not made for like t-shirts and stickers and stuff. I guess you could use it for stickers if you cut it out, but I think it's the best way to use this is on posters, and I'll show you exactly how to use it. So let's get into Leonardo. I'll show you the four different prompts and let's go from there. All right, so here we are on Leonardo.AI. You'll have to sign up and get Leonardo because it's app.leonardo.ai. So once you're signed up, you'll notice that they added a bunch of new featured models. So they keep innovating, they keep having more and more stuff. We're on Dream Shaper version 7 now. I think the one I did 3 months ago was version 4 or version 5. So they're like, keep learning, have some really cool stuff. Some 3D animation style, I think this is new, and absolute reality, pretty cool. So I'm gonna show you where Alchemy is. We're gonna use Dream Shaper version 7 just to show you the difference. And I'm gonna go down here to IA image generation, so click on there. And you can see I did one already just for practice, and we're gonna do one of those same ones. But I'm here, Dream Shaper version 7. If that's not already selected, select that. And then I'm gonna type in here, we're gonna do four different prompts. So we're gonna do one for a person, one for animals, one for a food, just so you can see how food looks like, and sceneries. And you can do lots more, but I think those four will kind of give you an idea how well it works. So we're gonna do person first. I'm gonna type in here, a woman pirate on a ship. Just, it can be anything, but I wanna give you some backgrounds too. So let's do that. Okay, so first, we're gonna turn off Alchemy, we're gonna turn off all of these. We're gonna just do Dream Shaper by itself with this prompt, and we'll show you how Leonardo does. And I think it will do pretty well by itself, but you're gonna notice a big difference. So this is Leonardo by itself, woman, pirate. The hand's kind of funky, sometimes that happens. But you can see it's okay. I mean, 3 months ago, this would be great, but let me show you what Alchemy does. Okay, I'm gonna turn on Alchemy, the beta. I'm gonna do high resolution, all of these. I'm just gonna turn on all the prompts. Okay, and same thing, same shape. We're just gonna do generate now. So I'm gonna put the two side by side. I'm gonna zoom in on this one when it's done. It's only gonna take a few seconds, just like the other one, and we'll see the difference. So this one kind of looks, the first one kind of looks, you know, cartoony compared to this one. It doesn't look like super high realistic. But check this out. Holy cow. The detail on the clothes and the ship here, and it's night and day. I'm gonna put these two together on screen here. And you can tell right away the difference between like a version 1 and a version 2 with Alchemy and high resolution. This is crazy. So this would make a great poster, right? You can just cut it right here. We may use this one. We'll see what the other ones turned out to look like. But I think this would be awesome as a poster. So you can do anything, a knight with a sword, a person doing different things. It could be just a modern person too in the streets or whatever. So I thought this would be really fun to do. So let's do an animal now. I'm gonna do just so simple. Again, you can do really, I'm just doing really basic prompts, but you can do prompts with more things in it to kind of give it more detail. But I'm just gonna do like a tiger in the jungle. Okay, I'm gonna turn it all off again so you can see like what does Leonardo do Dream Shaper by itself without Alchemy. I'm gonna hit generate, and this should be okay. I think Leonardo, most AI ones do tigers really well. So let's do here. You can see something's wrong with the eyes here, but you know, it looks like a tiger with two tails. Anyway, in the jungle, again, it looks like low res, right? So let's click out of here and do the same thing. I'm gonna turn Alchemy on, everything on, and let's generate. It's gonna only take a few seconds here again, but we're gonna see a big difference between the tiger we had before without Alchemy and the tiger with Alchemy. May take a little bit longer. Hopefully, crossing fingers that this works. So here's the tiger with Alchemy. Let me zoom in. Look at the detail of the tiger, the face, the eyes, the paws, like, and the trees. Like, Alchemy knows like realistic situations with it. This is made for, remember, Leonardo is made for gaming. So of course it's gonna just do super high res. Like, can you imagine this tiger in a game coming at you? This is pretty cool, right? So night and day, I'm gonna put the two together again. You can see before Alchemy and with Alchemy, night and day difference, right? Okay, so we know it does people, it does animals. Let's do food. I'm gonna do something really simple again. I love ramen, so I'm gonna do a bowl of ramen in a Japanese restaurant just to give some background. Let's do this. Oh, I'm gonna have to turn it all off, sorry. Turn it all off first. Okay, let's see. I didn't keep an eye on how much it costs. So 709, let's generate this and let's see what this does. Kind of curious what it does with just plain Leonardo. Okay, not bad. The egg doesn't look realistic and neither does the noodles. It looks like a computer generated drawing, right? So let's see what it does. And that was one, it was just one token. So maybe Alchemy costs a little bit more. I'm gonna see. All right, Dream Shaper, I got Alchemy on and hit generate. And we should see a big difference here as well. Just the quality, the sharpness and the details, right? So you saw that cost 8 tokens. So one thing is, if you're gonna use Alchemy, the difference in tokens, I didn't notice that before. So it was 8 tokens to do this and 1 tokens to do that. But check at the, holy cow, with all the details here, and kind of has a nice background, kind of that bokeh effect. And you can even see the steam coming off of the bowl, and even the bowl has details in here. It's pretty crazy. All right, so a little more costly, but if you're wanting to do more high fidelity, something more realistic, then that's the price you pay, is 8. So let's do one more. I'm gonna do scenery so we can see that. I'm gonna do a little bit different here. I'm gonna do a futuristic cyberpunk city at night with lots of lights. So all right, so cyber, oh, I got it right. A futuristic cyberpunk city at night with lots of lights. I'm gonna turn everything off again. All right, and I'm gonna generate. It should only cost me 1 token without everything off. So it should go down to $6.99. Yes, it did. And not bad, it's kind of cool. Okay, let's see how Alchemy does. I'm gonna turn it all on. And you know, maybe each one of these is a token. I don't know, I have to go back and look, but when I'm turning them all on, it costs 8. Okay, here we go, generate, everything on. Let's see how it does. Whoa. So here is what Leonardo with Alchemy does. Let's go in here. And it is amazing. It has cars, it has people in here, it has lights, even in background. So I didn't tell it to do that. I just did a simple prompt. You could ask it to do more things, you know, maybe 2 moons in the sky or different things to make it look like a foreign place. But wow, pretty cool, right? So I'll put these two side by side as well. And you can tell me which ones you think are the best. So all of these could make really great posters. I'm gonna do the cyberpunk one here. I'll hit download right here. So that will put it in my downloads folder. I'm gonna take that and bring it into another app called Pixelcut, and we're gonna scale it up so that it can fit on posters. So here I am on Pixelcut, create.pixelcut.ai. You'll have to sign in with your email, but it's totally free. It's in beta right now, so I don't know how long it's gonna be free, but it's free right now. They have different tools here. The one we're gonna use is this upscaler. So click on here, and we're gonna drag in that design that we made. So I'll put put it in here, boom. You can see it's a cyberpunk design. I'm gonna do it 4 times as big, right? And then it's gonna think about it. It's scaling it in the background right now, and it's already done. So I'm gonna hit download HD, and we can zoom in if we want to and see, like, it did upscale it, right? I'm gonna download the HD, and that's gonna also go to my downloads folder. I'm gonna bring this into any graphic design app that I can size it in. It can be Photopea, it can be Canva, it can be Affinity Designer, Illustrator, whichever one you had. I'll do it in Photopea since it's free, and I think everybody can have access to Photopea, so let's do that. All right, so here we are on Photopea. We're just gonna start a new project, and you're gonna make it the size of the poster that you want. So on this plate, you may not wanna put it on this plate, or you may not have this plate, but I'm gonna use the this plate size. Redbubble has their own sizes. Printful, if you're doing it through Printful, has its own sizes, but you'll put the width and height in here. So the width and height for this plate is 2900 pixels and 4060 here. And the background can be white, that's fine. And then we're gonna hit create. All right, so that's the poster size that we want. So before I drag it in, I wanna show you how much it upscaled it. So it did it 4 times, right? So the original from Leonardo was 1536 by 1024, but when I upscaled it, it's 6144 by 4096. And the height on this right here in Photopea, remember, is 4060, so it'll be okay. It's bigger than that. So when I drag it in, it may not fit the size right away. I'm gonna scale it up, and it's gonna be fine because I'm scaling it up to something smaller than it already is, the 4096, okay? So I'm gonna close these. I'm gonna drag in the bigger one right here, and it may come in smaller because it's gonna try and fit that. Oh, it went under. Huh, I was like, where did it go? There it is, okay. So the only reason it fit this way and not the whole thing is it's trying to fit the inside. So I still have room to drag it, and we're gonna do it to the top there, and then just drag the bottom here to fit the bottom. There you go. And then I can move it to a spot where I really want the poster to be, right there. And there you go, pretty cool poster, right? Now we could have done this with any of them. I'm gonna export this. So Display wants you to export it as a JPEG, not a PNG. So we're gonna do that. I'm gonna export as a JPEG right here. And you can see that's the size that we want, 2900 by 4060. Oh, and I probably want quality 100. And I'm gonna hit save. And there you go. That's it. I'll show you the final product in Display. All right, so here I am on Display. You may not have Display or have access to Display, but I'm gonna show you how you can do it on here. This will work for Redbubble or for any of the print-on-demand sites, but you can see these are the kinds of posters people are looking for, right? The kind of high definition. We have people, that pirate one would have been great here on Display too. I'm gonna do upload your artwork. I'll drag in that new project, that JPEG, bring it in here. I'm not a robot, so. And I can title it whatever I want, but I just wanna show you that it does work here. And I'm not gonna do all of these things. I have another tutorial on how to do Display, but you can see it worked. It's right in there. It's auto-cropping everything, and it may take a little while, so I'm not gonna show you that, but you can have this poster on Display. Let me show you what it looks like, the JPEG. This is what the poster would look like. I think it's fine like this, but if you wanted to add text on here or add more stars or whatever, I think that would be great too. Or you could redo the prompt. I think this would look really cool if it had like a couple of moons and planets in the background. That'd be really cool, right? So very high definition stuff that you can do with Alchemy in Leonardo, and I think it's great for posters, wall art, or anything like that. Well, there you go. That's Alchemy on Leonardo AI. I hope you can see the difference. I think it's mind-blowing. I think this is gonna be a game changer for posters, especially if you can do it on Display or any other of those. Some super high realistic stuff. So all you have to do is come up with a really good prompt, and I think there's lots of them out there. I showed you 4 different examples, but of course you can do more. If you wanna see more on how Leonardo is against Midjourney, I'll have to do another test with Leonardo Alchemy versus Midjourney. I think that would be a great test, but Leonardo before, I have this video right here. I did Leonardo versus Midjourney. You might wanna watch that to see the different prompts. I use the same exact prompts on both. So thanks again for watching this video. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.